Welcome to another video, and as you can see from the title above, this one is going to be a little bit more woo-woo, a little bit more alternative health, but that is something that I'm super duper passionate about. Right now I am on my way to becoming a health coach, so I'm getting a little bit more into alternative medicine. I just wanted to show you guys what I typically use for essential oils. Essential oils are so good for, you know, calming yourself down, for sleeping, for energizing yourself, and I find them to be a lot more natural, I guess, and pure compared to perfume. So even like with candles and scents and perfume, like those things I always try to avoid just because I know that they're chemical laden and I get a headache sometimes just smelling some of them. Whereas some of the essential oils that I'm going to show you today give you the same great smell without all the toxins. And if you know anything about toxins, a lot of them can also act as obesogens. So I mean, to put it into super duper oversimplified terms, they could help you gain weight. The obesogens, that is, not the essential oils. So let's go ahead and take a look. So the first one I have is called Clary Sage, and you can see from here. So what Clary Sage is, it is for balancing, and typically I put this on like anytime I feel a little bit ungrounded and I just need to feel a little bit more balanced and grounded in whatever I'm doing. Typically I also put this on at night because in the day I have other essential oils that would help me with energy and things like that. So Clary Sage is one of my favorites. Next, we have grapefruit. This is absolutely one of my favorite ones. It has a nice citrusy smell to it, and it's been said that grapefruit can help also aid weight loss. So what I would do is I would put this on maybe sometime during the day. It also says joyful underneath, so it can also, I don't know, maybe help with being more joyful. I love the smell of grapefruit. I used to eat grapefruit all the time in the morning, and now I can smell it with my essential oil, and it's absolutely wonderful. So I put this on typically earlier on in the day just for more energy. This one is called citronella. Citronella is slightly more orangey compared to the grapefruit one. So it's kind of like a blend of a lot of citrus flavors. And this one is a stabilizing. Now, I'm not too sure what that means, but I always know that citrus flavors help me wake up just a little bit more, and that's why I typically use this early on in the day, if not during the afternoon lull, like around 2 to 3 p.m. when I start to feel a little bit sleepy. Rosemary. Okay, so what's so great about rosemary is that it's actually, if you don't have the herb rosemary to use in any of your recipes, I would use just maybe like one drop of rosemary in the soup or in whatever it is that you'd want the flavor and the smell of. You might not know this, but all these essential oils, they're 100% pure, and you could eat them, you could apply them on your skin, you could put them in an aroma diffuser, which is what I typically do, just so that the air and mist diffuses in the room and the room just smells really, really good. Not to also mention it calms me down, it looks really pretty as well. So rosemary is known to be activating, so I use this early on in the day, not when it's in the evening, because I don't need that and I just need to calm down in the evening to prepare my body for sleep. Next is clove bud. So clove bud says motivating. So anytime that I am studying or I'm memorizing something and I don't want to do it, I put this on, and I can't say that it's like helped me. maybe it's the placebo effect. Do better at school, but I like the smell and I like the idea that it could potentially help me. And this is what I generally put on in the afternoon or in the mornings if I have time before a workout. If y'all know me, you know I love peppermint. I love anything peppermint. Peppermint taste, peppermint smell. I just love how invigorating it is, how fresh it is. And it's been said that it also helps with creativity and also helps with digestion. That's why you'll see a lot of herbal teas have peppermint in them, so that it helps, you know, soothe your stomach and your digestive system. So typically what I do with this, it also helps with migraines. I would just open this up, right? I would put one drop of liquid. There we go. Oh, that was two. One drop of liquid, and I would actually apply it just in my T area here and also on my temples. And also under my nose. And what this does, it will start to feel a little bit spicy, and that's okay. It's gonna last maybe 10 to 15 minutes. And it really helps clear migraines, headaches. Sometimes when you have like a stuffy nose, this is what I put right underneath my nose so that I can breathe it in. So that, oh, I'm already starting to feel the spice around my eyes. That's fantastic. You might tear up a little bit, that's okay. So yeah, I love peppermint. I love the smell. It has so many soothing benefits to it. This is birch tree oil. I haven't personally used this yet, but I have heard that birch tree oil and tea tree oil help with eliminating pests and bugs in the house. And currently I live in a house, a single room renting student housing thing, and there are bugs unfortunately around. So I haven't used it yet, but I will put this, I put maybe a few drops into my aroma diffuser, which I'll show you in a second, to help clear, wow, is my nose getting red? Okay. To help clear the air, just to make it, just so the bugs don't come out. Last but not least, I have one of my favorites. It's called bergamot. So bergamot is supposed to be uplifting. Anytime I am feel unmotivated or just a little bit stressed, I would put this on. It just smells good, period. All of these smell really good and they're pure. So this is my aroma diffuser. I named him Ooh because he oozes mist and I love it. And I actually got this brand from Now, and I'll link it in the description below where you can get it. What's so good about this is that you can take the top off, and when it's dark, you could double press it and it starts to light up. And it's just so calming. It's really pretty in the dark. I love it a lot. It calms me down a lot. And typically what I do is I put 10 drops of an essential oil, either just one, or I blend it up so that in total there's 10 drops of whatever I want. And then I put some water into it, some lukewarm water, and then I turn it on and I let it do its thing, and it fills up the room with such nice scents, depending on whatever, you know, essential oils I put inside, and I find it to be so calming and so soothing. All right, guys, that is a wrap for this video. If you have any questions, comments, I don't know, anything you wanna ask me below, let me know in the comments. And also don't forget to subscribe and let me know what other kind of videos you are into looking out for. All right, I'm gonna go before I turn into Rudolph, okay? Have a great day, guys. Mwah.